Welcome to a brief introduction and overview of Avaya's agent map. My name is Alex Lindberg with Avaya Professional Services. The topics to be discussed today are the features of agent map, the required and optional servers, connectors, and components, and the connectivity and information flow between these components. There will be a short demonstration of agent map's features in real time, and finally, where to go for more information. Agent Map provides a simple click-to-use GUI interface that shows, in real time, the status of all agents represented on the map. Agent Map is a read-only tool and does not require a CMS supervisor license or client to be installed. If a CMS supervisor client is installed and active, Agent Map will use it to provide administrative and skills management to the Agent Map user. When configured to use the optional ODBC connector to the CMS or IQ data store, the Agent Map server can download the names of the agents, skills, and VDNs for display on the Agent Map client. Without the optional connector, these names must be manually administered in Agent Map. When licensed and configured with third-party call control, the Agent Map client allows its user to barge in, dial, or monitor the agent by station ID or agent ID. The third optional component of Agent Map is an alarming and messaging service that provides for a text-like communication channel between the agents and their supervisors. The messaging may be one-way or two-way, and the messages can be canned or free-formed. Clients include a WML client for 9600 and 4600 phones, a web-based client for HTML access, and a desktop client for use on the agent desktop. Messaging capabilities can also be integrated into a custom desktop. Agent Map has two required components, an Agent Map server and an Agent Map client. The Agent Map server takes the generic RTA feed from a CMS or IQ server that provides real-time agent status, and optionally an ODBC connector to that same data store for the details of the agent's skills and vectors. An agent map server only monitors a single ACD. If there is more than one ACD on a CMS or IQ server, a separate agent map server will be required for each. In order to provide for third-party call control, the TCAPI client must be installed on the agent map server that connects to an appropriately configured AES server. And finally, a professional services enhancement to the CMS data store, sometimes referred to as D_login, adds a description field to the agent ID and name database record. The description fields for agents, VDNs, and skills can then be used by Agent Map to classify these sets of data. This graphic displays the connectivity between Communication Manager and AES, the CMS or IQ, the Agent Map server itself, the Agent Map client, and the optional alarm client that lives on the agent's desktop. Here is a brief example of some of the capabilities of Agent Map. It is important to know that all the information about Agent Map is stored on the server and not on the Agent Map client. Here is the real-time display of agent status. Each of these charts, representing a separate tab on our map, detail the total number of agents on that tab and the status of each agent. This tab shows all the agents configured on our map and the details of each. Zooming in allows us to see a little bit more detail. If you hover your mouse over an agent, the pop-up window will indicate the station of the agent's name, and agent ID, along with additional detail, including work mode and the VDN currently being serviced. Marcos, he has been in ACD state for custom box 0 for 10 minutes and 34 seconds. This agent has been on hold for a minute and 50 seconds. If you right-click on an agent, you'll you'll see some of the features available to the Agent Map user in the pop-up window. You can monitor, barge in, or dial the agent if you are licensed and configured for third-party call control. You can also manage agent skills if the CMS Supervisor client is installed and active. One of the most convenient features of Agent Map is the ability to alter the layout on demand with the appropriate authentication and attributes. The user can simply edit their maps to show the information they are interested in. In this case, we are going to add three new stations. The stations are 20247, 20248, and 20249. Notice in this case, we are adding stations, not agents. Let's add some text to describe these folks. They're the new agents. Let's make the text yellow and the background black. Save it, and we're done. Notice the new agents assigned to those stations are now displayed with their full agent name and information, Christina, Laura, and Nancy. The agent status is also displayed, on hold, on an active call, and available. Agent Map also provides the administrator the capability to set alarms based upon the duration an agent remains in a particular state. For instance, if you're interested in how long someone has been on hold, you can set both warning and threshold alarms. You can set alarms for the time in aux codes, skills based on ACD, or skills for ACW. A handy feature is an ability to do on-demand graphing of agent status. As an example, let's look at graph by skills. This graphic displays the skills of all the agents on this particular page. As we change pages or tabs, the graph changes. Here's an example of that same graph on the summary tab. Agent Map is available from Avaya Professional Services as an engagement. All servers are customer provided, whether as an appliance server or as a VMware host. For more information, see avaya.com and search for the phrase Agent Map, or visit the reference URL for a brochure and more information. Thank you for watching this introduction and overview of Avaya's Agent Map. Questions and feedback may be directed to mentor@avaya.com or on Twitter @AvayaMentor. For more details and technical support, please visit support.avaya.com.